Hey everybody, just want to do this package opening real quick. I got a football game on in the background, so that kind of distracts my mom a little bit. She's also doing the laundry, but yeah. I wanted to do a package opening today. Got two of them. One was actually scheduled to come tomorrow, but I guess I got a little ahead of schedule and got here today. I'm not sure about the one that's scheduled for Monday, if it's going to come tomorrow. We'll see. Destinated for Monday, we'll see. But I do have two packages. Right here. So let's see what they are, shall we? While I have this opportunity. So let's see what we have here. First one. And the first one, it was one. This one is, oh, it is a kind of digital, they just don't put it on the thing. And the first one we have here, we have it on Blu-ray as well. I think we have it on a confirmation of all of 3 to 4 spe- I think it's all 3 original specials and the new one, the sequel kind of on this one. But the one we have here is, here we have on 4K a Charlie Brown Christmas, the original Christmas special, if you will. And of course it's got the sequels on there. Got the sequels on there, I guess you could say the follow up and everything. It's got that on there. But yeah, the original Charlie Brown Christmas. So, and it's on 4K. And this was actually out on 4K before the Rankin Bass, but before Universal, who owns Rankin Bass, the Classic Media Division, put those specials out on 4K, I think, this year. So this was before it. But, and they actually have a compilation of all the specials, but this was the one everybody initially just, gets those compilations for. Outside of It's Great Pumpkin, this is the one mainly right here. So yeah. Pretty good. And I got the feature, Christmas Miracle, basically talking how it came about. But yeah, here we go, Charlie Brown Christmas on 4K. Alright, so yeah, that's 4K in it. My computer is loading right now. I don't know what it is, like when you don't use your laptop or something like that, the computer starts to load. So I don't know. So that's the first one. Alright, here's the second one. Had to have commercials come on, they get music, sometimes there might be copyright, so I don't want to get. Now here's the second one, this is a big one. So, let's see what this one is. First step, and well, this doesn't have a digital code, so I think it's digital. But we have the UK version. Hopefully, this works. Hopefully, this works. We have Ant-Man and Wasp on Quantumania. I was gonna get the 4K, but the 4K is out of stock, and then the other one wouldn't have come till December, so I might get that one too. But yeah, this is just the one disc, I guess you could say UK one, but mostly it's the one we got here in the state. So here it is, right here. I don't think there's much of a difference. And I think it does have special features, but yeah, it's the 4K version. And it's not the first time I've gotten a 4K version. I got Fantasia and Fantasia 2000, which are 4Ks, as well as one of my Beauty and the Beast Blu-rays as well. You know, that's the only way sometimes I can get them on Blu-ray. But yeah, I got this. I don't know. I don't know why places Amazon would have this, but I guess they have it just in case. They have it just in case, so we'll see. We'll see. And then here we have one that I did get on 4K. I was thinking, am I going to be able to get it? I looked. It's like with Amazon and other places, you got to like type it in and search it in real quickly. We have Guardians of the Galaxy Volume 3, the final volume. So now I have all three Guardians of the Galaxy. And as of right now, as of getting these right now, I am up to date on the Marvel Cinematic Universe collection that I have. So yeah, we've got this right here. It's got a nice embossed cover. So pretty cool. But yeah, got this movie. So got all three of them. That's pretty cool. And of course, like I say, got Ant-Man and Wasp, Quantumania, which again, for some reason, the 4K one is sold out. Maybe I can find it elsewhere. But there we go. And then last but not least, this is the first. I have a lot of Bluetooth speakers, but this is the first one I've gotten of this brand. Like I said, the first of what? Oh, sorry. When they do highlights, they like to be real loud. But like I said, it's the first Bluetooth speaker. What I was trying to say is I have Bluetooth speakers of different brands and everything, but it's the first time I've ever gotten a Bluetooth speaker or any kind of speaker from this brand, and it's been one of the more advertised brands out there. In fact, it is not just one of the more advertised brands, it's one of the more sought after brands, it's one of the more expensive brands, sometimes depending on what you're getting. And it's one of the rare brands that has about 5 stars all the time. And it's been advertised in commercials, infomercials, as to, when it has its surround sound, its sound bars and all that, that you get that crisp theater feel. And what did I get? Well, got a shout out to Black Nerd Comedy, Andre Meadows, for showing this off in his, cereal video that he did, talking about, the various different kind of licensed cereals or series we had back in the 80s and 90s, licensed or not. He showed this off as a sponsor because they sent him one. And I was like, okay, if it's that good, because he did put it to his mic, his microphone, and he had it on the bottom left-hand corner of the screen saying music from the speaker. And it does sound really good. And every review I have seen has said pretty much the same thing. Yeah, there was a few 1 star, 2 stars. But I think sometimes, as I've mentioned before, those 1 to 2 stars are just competition is what they are. They're just competition, acting like their customers, just so acting like their customers, talking down on on something like this, just so they can, get you to go to buy their item instead. And a lot of people make comparisons to this and the JBL stuff that's come out lately, that seems similar. And a lot of people have said that either they're about the same, and some have said the JBL is a little better, but from what I've seen, a majority have said that this one is better. And which one is it? How about the Bose SoundLink Flex? Yes, the Bose SoundLink Flex. Apparently, this came out, I think, like last year or something, I think, or a year before. I can't really recall. I don't know what the year is. On this. Last year, it's last year, 2022. So, what's funny about this is, what's funny about this, you look on YouTube and some videos say it's about been 2 years. So I'm wondering if maybe that's just like CNET and all of them that got advanced copies. Before it was fully fledged out, but this is one that came out last year, and I don't know why Andre was talking about it now. Usually he would talk about it, like when it first comes out, because he has connections and everything, so. But obviously this is one of those situations where Bose is like, hey, let's send him this because it's still kind of new. And I'm assuming that when they send it to him, it was for it's been about it when they send him a copy. That it probably it was a year. It probably celebrated 1 year since its release, so it's still fairly new. I mean, there are some that are a little lower at like 125, but they're the used and like new, advertised under them. This is the new one, and it's got 5 stars on Amazon. And like I said, most of the reviews are positive. Some that are negative, I think, are mostly from the competition and everything. A lot of people, like I said. When they compare this to the newest JBL speaker that came out around the same time, and even one some of the Sony ones that came out around the same time, some of them will say, some of them will say that the JBL sounds better, the Sony sounds better. Some will say they're all on equal par, but a majority from what I've seen on YouTube and reviews will say that this sounds better than both the JBL and the Sony, so we'll see about that. And some say it all depends, like on how you position it. If you tilt it up, you'll get good sound. You put it this way, you get good sound. We'll see about that, and I might do an unboxing of it later. But yeah, that's pretty much it for the package opening. Like I said, got these here, as well, these movies, and I got the JBL both. So, yeah, that's pretty much it for this package opening. Let me know what your thoughts are down below as I put the one back on and the. So, put it back on, so kind of throws her off a little bit. But let me know what your thoughts are, guys, down below. Comment if you like, and I'm out.